Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Ara. I am a 39-year-old mother of five, beauty and fitness lover. I am ashamed. Because I'm going to be doing a video on everything I bought and forgot. Don't judge me too harshly. Actually, keep your judgment to yourself. I bought a whole bunch of makeup that I tossed in a drawer and completely forgot that I bought it, and today's the day I'm gonna use it. So I'm gonna do just a little something different today. I know this is absolutely shameful, and you guys feel free to judge, just please keep it nice. We all make mistakes, we all do things that in hindsight we wish we didn't do. This is not something I bought and forgot. This is just a new love, a new obsession. I'm actually just gonna prime my face first with my Danessa Myricks Yummy Skin Moisture Repair Serum. This thing is heavenly for me. I just got out of the shower a little while ago, so I want a little bit extra moisture before I go in with every other product. Honestly, to use what I have, storage is an issue, so lose track of things that I don't ordinarily do. If I can't find something, it's easy for me to forget that I have it, and that contributes a little bit to my problem. Two, I am a huge sucker for packaging, so if I see something with gorgeous packaging, I typically buy it and give it a shot. If the packaging is off-putting, sometimes not so much. I do not have a color corrector that I don't like, so I'm just gonna do a color correcting really quickly and then jump into the rest of this. To start this off, the first foundation I bought and completely forgot to use it. I bought it in the wrong undertone. So the shade, when I bought it last summer, late summer, early fall, the depth of it was okay. I forgot to use it, but the depth was okay. The undertone was the wrong undertone. And I can't remember why exactly I went with this one, but I did. This beautiful product right here that everyone loves, and it's starting to come back around now. This is the Chanel Les Beiges Water Fresh Complexion Touch Foundation. I know everyone's talking about it now because of the new drugstore one. I can't remember which one that is. However, I bought it last summer and I remember swatching a bit of it and thinking, oof, I don't think that's gonna work for me. I think I need to send it back for a different shade or something. Something came up and I completely forgot to do it and I never got around to using it. I bought the shade B20. Now all of my other foundations for Chanel are BR12 or BR22, depending on the season. So it's a neutral undertone, which is fine in the summer months. In warmer months, it's totally fine because I spend enough time outside and soak up enough sun. It's not a big deal. And to be quite honest, usually during the summer, I'll use some sort of in-shower sun tint. Yeah, I'll talk about that at another time, but it works. The undertone is much better than if I had picked out a golden undertone. I just forgot to use it. I forgot to pull it out and just give it a go. And I can't remember what it was that I was doing, but I'm actually gonna just take, oh, maybe I can just break it up. I'm gonna use a sponge for this instead of a brush. Take two pumps. I think I'll just do two pumps and start from there and see how I like it. I mean, we're gonna pretend that I have a decent amount of sun on for this video. I mean, I definitely do not, but as long as I don't show you too much of my arms, we should be okay. The little beads on here were the selling point for me because I thought it was so cute. I remember first buying it because of Martina Lily. So yes, I 100% blame you, Martina, because the first one that you had, it was too sheer. I didn't want to just buy a product like that. Which one was that? The Water Fresh, Les Beiges Water or something. I didn't want that because I just felt like, whoa, that's way too expensive to just wear under my makeup and it doesn't give me enough coverage. And then when this one came out, I was like, I like it. That's cute and innovative. I want it. And I didn't play with it. I bought it and I didn't play with it. So shame on me. I do not have a concealer that I bought and forgot, thankfully. I'm a little more cautious with concealers. I don't know what it is. I have bought concealers and hated them, given them a fair chance, hated them and just trashed them. But none that I just like bought and stuck in a container and forgot they were there. And I don't have a lot of concealers, so they all kind of fit in that bin and they're easy to see and find. But I'm gonna use my Tom Ford Shade and Illuminate Concealer. This is in the shade 1C0 Silk. I bought this not long ago and loved it and haven't gotten enough use out of it. So I'm just gonna go ahead and use this one. And it's slightly too deep for me for winter. So I would need to get a different shade for winter, which is fine. I like the applicator, the little doe foot here. It's nice and soft, has some flexibility. That's what I'll say about that. I'm really hoping that my powder helps lighten this situation up just a touch. I'm really loving this complexion so far. I am very guilty of buying too many powders. Thankfully though, I use the majority of my powders. They all have a special place in my heart and routine. I did buy the original color of the Uoma powder, Trip and Smooth powder. I bought it in the first shades that were launched. And then a few months, like maybe even a year later, Translucent was launched. I bought Translucent and never used it. I only ever liked it for summer because it was a little more drying than I liked. And I don't do well in the winter with matte, very matte powders. I'm gonna hope this does not ruin my under eyes. But I'm gonna give it a go. Let me just get the powder on the cap. And just kind of work it into my powder puff here so I can get these crevices in my forehead. And I tend to be a little aggressive when I powder my forehead though. Maybe I shouldn't press as hard and just let my head do what it does. Let me just dust away all this excess because I don't need all this excess here. This is the product that actually hurts me the most. The Chantecaille Bronzer that was launched last summer. This one hurts the most because it is wildly overpriced and so pretty. This packaging is so pretty. I never touched it and played with it. I'm so disappointed in myself because, like, there was no reason for me not to. There was no reason to not enjoy what I have. And I've been meaning to compare it to the Sicily bronzer that I bought. I definitely don't need bronzers. I've got several that I love, but I mean, it was so pretty. I'm not actually sure how this is gonna look on my skin with this foundation though. It should be okay. I'm gonna use a Sonia G brush. This is the Jumbo Bronzer. It's a big gelée, so maybe this brush will be okay for it. Oh, I like this bronzer. And maybe because I use this brush, it's looking more diffused. Normally I've been using my denser Sigma brushes, but oh no. Well, I'd rather love what I already paid for and use it, so ignore me. Okay, I am thoroughly in love with this bronzer so far on first impressions. I'm glad I bought it. Can't believe it took me so long. I will definitely have to compare it to the Sicily bronzer. Because I wasn't a big fan of that one. Oh, for blush, the holiday collection for Valentino, the Eye to Cheek. This one is shade number 3. It doesn't actually have a name on it though. I don't know the name. There's no name. It just says number 3. I don't care for the packaging. Like, let me turn this upside down so the mirror doesn't blind you. I do not care for the packaging. I think the packaging is flimsy and boring and cheap. This thing is so pretty and sparkly. Ooh, I don't know if it's gonna match my eye makeup. It's got the little brush that I'll never use sitting here in this little crevice. This is a Sydney Grace brush. I'm just gonna pick it up. Ooh, it's got the little pearl look to it. Honestly, this would look so much better with my fair skin. I don't have any other Valentino blushes, and I was like, oh, it's a cute package. Let me buy that one. And now here I am. March. I bought it, what, November, December, somewhere around there. So the formula feels lovely. It reminds me of the Armani formula. It's very pretty. I think it'll work for my eyeshadow, so I'm not too concerned there anymore. What do we think? I mean, I think in the winter, this shade being as light as it is, it's gonna look a lot better. This highlighter I had all the best intentions of using in a different video. Never got around to using it in that video because I used something else. And then it's been in the back of my mind to use it. This is the Westman Atelier Peau de Santé Super Loaded Tinted Highlighter. And I remember saying in that video, I'm gonna have to come back and use it in a different video. I haven't actually put it on my face. I've only ever swatched it. It's got that really pretty pinky golden like tone to it that's perfect for summer. I think it'll be okay over this blush. I don't mind putting it over a powder. What I'm gonna do is pick it up with kind of like the I think I'll pick it up like on the point kind of on my sponge and then just kind of work it into my palm. This might have worked better before putting down the blush so I could see the tone of it a little bit more. Interesting. No highlight. It's not tacky. It's not tacky at all. Definitely has a dry down. That's nice. I think I like that a lot more than the stick highlighter of Westman Atelier's. I love Natasha Denona. I do. I swear I do. I bought her lipstick last year when I saw it on sale. It's the I Need a Nude Amorosa lipstick. I bought it, I stuck it in my little lipstick container, and I forgot to use it. Look, I mean, you can, it's so sad. I'm sad. Just, no words. It still smells good. That's good. I do not have a lip liner that matches it. I did not even buy that lip liner. I'm just gonna use my new Hourglass lip liner. I know totally off topic for this video, but I am loving that new Hourglass lip liner. Let's give it a go. I like it. Okay, so it's not necessarily my favorite tone for a nude, but I like it. I think with my undertone, I like more pinky nudes. This one, I mean, it's got that pink undertone to it, but it's a little more beige, like more beige than pink. Am I making sense? Probably not. So far, so good. I'm gonna go ahead and contour my nose off camera, do my eyebrows off camera, and then I'll do my eye makeup with you when I come back. You guys, I had the best intention with this. I swear, I really did. I have been so intrigued by Byredo. I have been. The Remembrance palette was not up my alley. I used to watch Alicia Archer's videos when she would get her Byredo products and I'd be like, man, there is something about those palettes. Cause I remember the first two palettes she got that she did videos on. I was like, ooh, I really like that, but I'm not really sure that it's my color story. And then I saw their little quince. I believe it's a quint. And I've always been fascinated by them. I thought the little rock packaging was so cute. They finally released a color story right up my alley, the purple one. I like purples, I do. Reminds me of my childhood. And honestly, I never touched it. I bought it, I never touched it. I just love it. It's so cute. The packaging, let me tell you, this thing is sturdy, it's weighty, it feels luxurious. Oh, it feels luxurious in my hands. It's so pretty. It's got a little bit of a duochrome purpley shift here, where it goes from dark purple, more of a light purple there. Not sure if the camera picks that up, but I see it in the mirror. There's not a single swatch to this, not a single indent from a brush. I've only ever admired it. Moment of truth. I know this was compared a lot to the Viseart palette, Violette, the Viseart Violette palette. So there's only one matte in this palette, which limits what I can do, or at least what I want to do. This is my only matte shade. The rest of these are shimmers. And I think the silver one here is a topper. Maybe I should just sweep that purple all across my lid. I'm going to use a Refer 27 brush and pick it up here. No turning back now. Maybe I should just put that all over my lid. I should have used a packing brush to put it on my lid, so it's not actually patchy. Not yet, anyway. I don't know. I'm just using a fluffy pointed brush. Ooh, I like the tone of this purple. Let me just try packing that on with a flat packing brush. This is the Sonia G Worker. And see if I can make it more opaque on my lid. There's no patchiness to it, but it's definitely a more sheer purple than what I initially thought, which doesn't surprise me. It's a luxury brand. I'm gonna leave this alone where it's at, go get my son from preschool, and then come back and finish this. I'm gonna be honest, I don't remember where I left off. It's been a while, and I just fed my son, and I've got baby drool all over my shoulder, so just bear with me. Let me try a denser synthetic brush. I'm gonna use my Singe E04 brush. Let's give that a go instead. Okay, let's try this. Huh, not a whole lot of difference in depth with this shadow versus the matte. Like, I'm trying to build up this purple on my lid and it's not really building. Not really giving me much of anything. I'm definitely having to work at it more than I'd like to. Maybe what I need to do is just move on and use a different shade. I mean, I can tell already this is not gonna be my best look. I'm gonna give this a little bit of help. I'm gonna use my NYX glitter glue, kind of layer it over the other purple shimmer. I'm gonna use my finger and pick up this deep violet shade here. And I hope that the warmth of my finger and this tacky glue will help. It's definitely not impactful, but also it's a luxury brand and I'm used to luxury brands being more subdued. It's okay so far. Let me try using this shade here to kind of build up that inner third of my lid. Oh, don't press too hard. That one seems like it's a little softer. I don't know if I want to. This one has more of that duochrome shift. I think what I'll do instead is use this pale icy shade here without digging and just slap that all on the inner corner. It's definitely really hard pressed. I'm not getting much of anything. Well, there's not a whole lot I can do with that. Okay. I think what I'll do before my battery dies is take this duochrome shade on the tip of my brush and just use that to create an illusion here in my socket. You might have already noticed that I am not fond of this look. So this eye caught up. I'm gonna try to do my lower lash line. I'm not feeling motivated because this just, I'm not happy with my first impression. So this is a Refer 03. I'm just gonna pick it up on the tip and start here on the outside corner. I'm not gonna swipe because it's sheer. I just wanna press. I'm gonna take in Ascend's E02 and just, without poking myself, gently diffuse. I want to do something here without making a mess of this look. I'm gonna take the duochrome shade. I'm trying to keep this in focus so you can see it without, I mean, I guess I don't have to be so awkward about it, but I'm gonna pick it up here on a clean Refer 03 brush and sweep it from my inner corner underneath my lash line. I'm gonna finish this off by taking this very faint topper shade on a small, am I even getting anything? No, is it just too hard pressed? Nothing is coming off on that brush. So I'm just gonna clean off this, I cleaned off this Refer 03, pick it up on the tip of this brush. Yeah, there's just so much hard paint on here. It's just, I can't get anything. I wanted to just kind of top it over this little duochrome shade, but it's not doing anything. This is just such a disappointment for me. I'm gonna tight line with my Lisa Eldridge pencil. Just gonna give it a little depth out here. Just as a disclosure, whatever is in this eyeshadow formula is really affecting my eyes. I am tearing up on both outside corners here. I'm definitely sensitive to whatever this formula is. I'm gonna just wipe away a little bit of that fallout. I didn't get a whole lot, so that's good. I did have to touch up this outer corner here. I'm so disappointed. This is a ColourPop gel pencil in Crybaby. I don't have a mascara or liner that I don't use that I bought and neglected, so I'm just gonna use my Lisa Eldridge and come back and just finish this all off because my feelings just are so down now. The lashes I used, I got another set of the Kiss New Natural Lashes. This one's in the style Gold Hoops. The last item that I have, which I bought and didn't use, is the Uoma Hydroblast Finishing Powder. I have mine in the shade White Pearl. Well, I mean, I guess it's a sign to go ahead and use it. All right, well, let's see what happens. Ugh, that's an odd scent. Ugh, what an odd scent. Ugh. Why am I still using it? What is that smell? Oh my gosh. I'm like writhing in my skin. My eyes are bothering me so bad from this eyeshadow. And that powder, oh my God, let me just start with the powder. I just took the seal off. You saw it go poof. It smells atrocious. It's why I put it all over my face, I do not know. I just, stupidity gets a hold of me sometimes. It smells like mildew. I don't even wanna smell it again. It smells like mildew. I love Uoma. I love their products. I love their foundation. There's something about this powder that it felt nice. It felt nice. It felt nice and cooling. I mean, I don't even want to judge the finish of it because I'm pretty sure it's bad. I'm pretty sure this has just gone bad. It smells horrendous. I gotta throw it away. I can't say anything. I just gotta throw it away. There's nothing I can say because I don't even want to buy a fresh one to give that a fair chance because I only had that for about 6 months. It should not smell rank after 6 months, especially after taking that seal off. I can't do it. I can't do it. I love powders. I love Uoma, but I can't buy another one of those. I'm sorry. The eyeshadow. This is my first experience with Byredo. I had such high hopes because I have been waiting for them to release the color story that I would like. I know I bought it like 9 months ago or somewhere around there. It wasn't that long ago. This purple matte is so sheer, which is fine. I mean, that's fine. You blend it out, or even when I packed it on the eye, you could see it was still sheer. I don't mind that there's only one matte. The duochrome is the best one in this palette. Like, that is the best shadow in this palette. And there's not a whole lot of opacity to it. This shade here, on the end, it's already hard painting. It just looks like gray, like a gray shadow. Not much of anything. I'm so sad. The dark purple here. It's pretty, but it's not giving. It's not giving. It's just there. It's there. Yeah, it's just there. The shimmer, the topper that already hard panned on me, this silver with purple reflect, already hard panned on me. I am like digging in there. There is like nothing there. It barely transformed my look. It barely did anything. I got nothing nice to say about this palette. Honestly, it looks better as a paperweight on my vanity. It just looks like a beautiful duochrome purple rock that I picked up out of the ocean. I should just leave it on my vanity as just like something pretty to look at and maybe like hold down my lashes. I don't know. The Amorosa lipstick from Natasha Denona. I love it. It's a beautiful nude. I do. I'm not sure it's the best for my skin tone, my undertone, but I like it. I already have a couple of her lipsticks. I do love the formula, so I just didn't use it. Bronzer, the Chantecaille Bronzer. Woo! Packaging, beautiful, beautiful. The finish of this bronzer, wow. I love it. I love it. So I know I only use the one bronzer brush. I'm going to try a different bronzer brush next time because this was pretty. This was way too expensive to not use. I don't know. Something, it just ended up in my drawer and I didn't use it. I'm so boring. I just got nothing to say to justify it. For like $90-ish. I should have used it. I don't remember how much I paid, but wow. I wasn't even that impressed when I used the Sicily bronzer, and I know everyone's been comparing this one to that. This one was nice. I will have to pull them out and do a comparison though. The Valentino Blush. I know I already reamed it for the packaging. I don't really care for the packaging. The blush is so pretty. This shade in particular, I think looks better on me with my fair skin. But I think the formula is just as good as the Armani formula and the Luminous Silk Blush. And I think it's just as good as my Gucci blush because I have one of those too. So like if I were to just pick, I mean, I have to say the packaging for the Gucci and the Armani is so much better, so much nicer, so much more luxurious. This is just There's nothing to this that screams luxury to me. It's very bleh. And I'm pretty sure this shade looks very similar to the one for Armani. So I'm going to have to compare it because I have that shimmer shade from Armani. It's pretty. I like it. But it's not special. And I like special. The highlighter, I already stuck it back in here because I don't like getting this beautiful, like, heavy paperweight thing scratched and dirty. It's so pretty to look at and hold and feel. This little package just makes it that much better. I like it, but I need to use it without a blush underneath and just see if, like, I can use it as a hybrid blush highlight, like, combination. It's very pretty. I don't really have anything negative to say about it. I just need to use it a couple more times. The Uoma powder, I already knew that I liked this, so this wasn't even a big deal. I don't have anything negative to say. It's not my favorite powder, not by a long shot. I like it. It's a matte powder. It makes my skin matte, so it works great for summer. I definitely don't use it, or at least the other one that I have. Never used it for the winter. Won't be using it for the winter. I don't like it with this foundation. I prefer the look the foundation gave me without this. And I had that Denona Myrix balm underneath my foundation. And this basically, like, sucked all the juiciness out of my skin. Sucked all of the luminosity out of my skin. So I don't like it with this. And the last thing I want to talk about is this Chanel foundation. I love it. Spoiler alert. I love it. Undertone works just fine. Honestly, I don't need to get BR22 for summer. This undertone works just fine. It blended out into my skin just fine. I mean, you can barely tell. I've got so many freckles too, but you can barely tell. And when I kind of tan up a little bit from working in the garden and being outside with the kids, it'll look even better. The powder I used definitely isn't helping because, I mean, yeah. But this is so, so nice. I don't know why I just left it there on my shelf. I'm terrible. That's going to be it for me today. I'm going to hurry to be done. Sorry. Oh my gosh. I can't even do an outro. Everything on my face will be linked down in the description box below if you are somehow intrigued and are curious about using them for yourself. Those links are affiliated. You are supporting my channel. You definitely do not have to use my links at all. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you've watched all the way to this point, do something for yourself today because you are worth it.